Hi, here we have a function generator, an amplifier and a loudspeaker. With this setup, we can make any sound in the world, anything that you like. You want some filthy bass? Here you go. Whoa, 40 to 400 hertz. How about some spaceship sounds? Sweep function from 10 hertz to 3 kilohertz. And if you want to hear something annoying, well, you should call your ex. I could literally sit here and generate hundreds of different sounds and just watch this speaker vibrating. But I lied. This setup is primitive and won't generate any type of sound that I want. It cannot recreate a water drop, for example. This amplifier adds its own vibes at certain volume levels and passes out when it's just too much for it. This amplifier operates very well for its purpose, as well as this speaker. For high quality sound, you can go with trusted and well-known brands and even design your own TV room to squeeze out the juice from your hi-fi system. However, for signaling someone or alarming them, you can use those buzzers. On TME's website, we can find small and large loudspeakers, electromagnetic sounders, piezoelectric signalers, and various types of microphones. Let's see what's the difference between them and what's their applications. The buzzer is an electric device that produces a tone or an alarm sound and can be found in household appliances, alarm systems, timers, and America's Got Talent. The piezoelectric buzzer, like this siren, is a signal generator of one tone and works in the principles of piezoelectric effect. In this case, it is a reversed effect in which the sound pressure variation is generated by putting the material in an electric field. How amazing that we have such materials that can generate electric potential if it is mechanically deformed and vice versa. Those small and yet highly effective buzzers have long service life and high reliability. They can be easily combined with another control circuit to produce a variety of pure and loud tones. The other type of buzzer is the electromagnetic one, which works on the principle of electromagnetic induction, which was discovered by Michael Faraday. The motion of a magnet with respect to a coil or a change in the magnetic field induces a potential differences in the coil and produces induced current. In other words, inside of the electromagnetic buzzer, we have a ferromagnetic material and a coil, which produces a magnetic field when we drive a current through it. When current drives through the coil, the ferromagnetic plate and the coil are attracted. Now all that is left is to repeat thousands of times per second and we get a sound. Other buzzers and loudspeakers work on the same principles. And by the way, those piezoelectric materials are also used in electric lighters. Except that here you apply pressure which is converted into electricity. And with this fun fact, it's time to go.